Now we'll look at three examples on how to graph a line given the slope of the line as well as the y-intercept of the line. The y-intercept is sometimes referred to as the vertical intercept. Remember, to graph a line on the coordinate plane, we do need at least 2 points on the line. And the y-intercept is 1 point on the line. It's a special point. It's the point where the line intersects or crosses the y-axis. So we'll begin by plotting the y-intercept of -7, which should be here on the y-axis. We often use the variable b to represent the vertical intercept. So we can say that b is equal to -7, and notice how the y-intercept would have coordinates 0, comma, -7. And now we'll find additional points on the line using the slope. And we're given the slope is equal to 2/5. We normally use the variable m to represent the slope, where the slope is equal to the vertical change divided by the horizontal change along the line. We can also say it's the ratio of the vertical change to the horizontal change. And it's also often referred to as the change of y divided by the change of x. So here the slope m is equal to 2/5, which means along our line, when the vertical change is positive 2, the horizontal change is positive 5, which means starting at the vertical intercept, because the vertical change is positive 2, we would go up 2 units, and then because the horizontal change is positive 5, we would go right 5 units to here. Again, we can also say the change of y is positive 2, so we go up 2, and the change of x is positive 5, so we go right 5. So notice how by using the slope, we found a second point on the line, so now we can graph the line, or we can also use the slope again to find another point on the line. And if I go up 2 units and right 5 units, this point is also on our line. This is a line that has a slope of 2/5 and a y-intercept of -7. Verifying the slope again, notice from this point, we went up 2 units and right 5 units because the slope was 2/5. Let's look at another example. Here we're asked to graph a line that has a slope of -2 and a y-intercept of +5. So we know the line intersects or crosses the y-axis at positive 5, which is here. We can also say b equals 5, and the y-intercept has coordinates 0, comma 5. To find additional points on the line, we can use the slope, where we're given the slope is equal to -2. But in order to use the slope to graph the line, we do want the slope in fraction form. So let's write the slope as -2 over positive 1. So now here, notice how the vertical change, or the change of y, is -2, and the horizontal change, or the change in x, is +1. So here, because the vertical change is -2, we're going to go down 2 units from the y-intercept, and then because the horizontal change is +1, we're going to go right 1 unit. And again, we can do this multiple times, down 2, right 1, down 2, right 1, down 2, right 1, down 2, right 1. Notice how all these points are on the same line. This is a line that has a slope of -2 and a y-intercept of +5. Verifying our slope, notice how from the vertical intercept we went down 2 units and right 1 unit, again because the slope was -2 over +1. Let's look at one more example. Same question, but now we have a slope of -2/3 and a y-intercept of 0. So our line crosses or intersects the y-axis at 0, which would be this point here at the origin. So we can also say b equals 0, and therefore the y-intercept has coordinates 0, comma 0. And now we can use a slope of -2/3 to find additional points. So the slope is equal to -2/3. To keep things clear though, we need to put the negative sign in the numerator or denominator. Let's go ahead and put it in the numerator. So let's write the slope as -2 over +3. So because the numerator is -2, the vertical change or the change in y is -2, and because the denominator is +3, the horizontal change or change in x is +3, which means from the vertical intercept, we're going to go down 2 units because the vertical change is negative, and right 3 units because the horizontal change is positive. And again, we can do this multiple times, down 2, right 3, down 2, right 3. Now, I do want to point out one more thing here. If we wrote the slope as +2 over -3, that still works. But if it's written like this, we'd actually go up 2 units and then left 3 units. And let's try this to make sure we do get the same line. So going back to the y-intercept here, let's go up 2 and left 3, up 2, left 3, up 2, left 3. Notice all these points are on the same line. So here's a line that has a slope of negative 2/3 and a y-intercept of 0. Verifying the slope one last time, notice how we went down 2 and right 3. When we use a slope of negative 2 over positive 3, when we use a slope of positive 2 over negative 3, we actually went up 2 units and left 3 units, which did give us a different point on the line, but it did give us the same line. I hope you found this helpful.